This is a familiar sight in the Australian bush, the blackened aftermath of the ravages of fire. Only this time, the fire was lit on purpose and for the benefit of the environment. It's been known for a long time that fire is a natural part of the outback. In northern Australia, many low-intensity fires are lit early in the dry season in order to reduce the extent of more damaging wildfires that inevitably occur later in the season. But information was needed on what was the best way to go about burning off and the consequences of different types of burning. So the world's largest bushfire experiment, covering 250 square kilometres, was lit at Kapalga Research Station in Kakadu National Park. As part of an 8-year study, 12 large areas were set alight and controlled by a group of researchers from Australia's science agency, CSIRO, universities and government agencies.
We tested four different types of fires. We tested fires that we burned early in the dry season, about May, fires that we lit late in the dry season, about October, and they're the highest intensity fires that we can get up here. Fires that we lit progressively through the dry season as the country dried out, and then no burning at all, completely unburned.
The researchers recorded the height of the flames, the intensity and spread of the fires lit at these different times of the year. They then studied the effects on streams, plants, animals, including insects, and greenhouse gases. They found that the savanna ecosystem was highly resistant to fire, and surprisingly, populations of most plants and animal species were not even affected by high-intensity fires. Some animals, including the frill-neck lizard, actually decreased in number when there was no burn-off at all. Many animals were affected by fire, but the intensity of the fire did not appear relevant. The main implication of the study is that conservation managers need to take more account of how often fire occurs rather than the fire's intensity. The Kapalga fire burning study has revealed that in many parts of the top end, fires are happening too frequently to sustain healthy populations of many animal species.